Hello and welcome to the GT Planet Fantasy Series, live from the Armory Digital Super Speedway in Seattle, Washington. NASCAR fan 1400 had the pole. Him and Ninners would lead us down for the first lap of a 175-mile-long race. Off into turn one, NASCAR fan would get the early lead, and BK Glover would be right behind him. Swift Smith all the way down on the double blue line. All the way up to the outside wall is Ninners. Coming out of turn four, BK Glover would get an arrow push from the number 50 of Swift Smith, would get alongside NASCAR fan and would be able to take the lead and lead the first lap by about a half a car length. It wouldn't be long though before the pack started to fan out into three and four wide. This is a view from Silver Wing sitting toward the back end of the pack. But look at them already as they go three wide, trying for four wide. By lap five, everybody had gotten situated and we were going four wide and three wide everywhere. ABP would soon be in the lead at that point. As you can see by the field, there are cars everywhere, and that would be the key. That would be the tone all day. Already a car off the pace with a mechanical issue. That is for Rinkazin. He had been leading the points a couple rounds ago, not anymore. You can see here that clearly he's not terribly down a lot. And there you see five wide somehow working. Ferguson wasn't terribly off the pace, but he just lost the draft, and I guess his aerodynamic package, maybe a little too much downforce. You see three wide, four wide everywhere on lap 12 of 68. That's B-Man, the shootout winner. He knows how to work the restrictor plate tracks. Speeds of over 180 miles an hour. And they're all three wide and all four wide. It's just a wall of cars. NASCAR fan 1400 would finally lead a lap. Despite starting on the pole, it took him 12 laps to lead one. There's Quiet Girl in the number 87, giving the female population of GT Planet some pride, taking the lead. She would lead a few laps and then soon have to relinquish it. The Cybertron in the lead. This is an onboard shot, just showing you what it's like to be in the pack in a place like this with cars everywhere. You can't. There is nowhere to go. I mean, you can see there is nowhere to go. If something were to happen in front of you, you're just along for the ride. Four wide for the lead with Quiet Girl, Jarragini. Now five wide as the Cybertron sticks his nose in there, as well as GT Racer 98 and Samurai 8 Juice. I don't know how they made that one work. Very impressive there. Now it's down to three wide, and Jarragini would go along the inside down the double yellow or double blue line. See them all four, three, and four wide behind them scattering around and door-dinging each other. By around lap 30, the Cybertron would start to put out a bit of a lead with Mega Umbreon and Jaggy right behind. Durr winning right behind teammate Jaggy, just trying to help out and see if they can't get to the front. Here you can just see how big this pack is, how crazy it is with everybody three wide and darting around, changing lanes. It is the most controlled chaos you're going to see all season, more than likely. The only thing that I can think would beat it out is Talladega, which it almost did, but Daytona next week. Here you see the running order at the top left of the screen as the field flies by. Everybody except for Ferencizen is still in the lead pack. Now, here's where it would sort of get a little crazy. You see, Gran Turismo 916 makes a scheduled pit stop, but he does it all by himself. Not one other driver comes in with him. So he is now a sitting duck and pitting all by himself. And what they end up doing is they take two tires and however much gas it would take to fill in those time. They drop the jack and he's off. They know they have no drafting partners, so they're just hoping for some luck here. You see as the rest of the field begins to make their pit stops. This is a cycle. These next few clips will be cycles over the next four or five laps. This is the first lap. This is the second lap. Here's the third lap. Right here. The first lap was Gran Turismo all by himself. And then here is the fourth lap. which is just the rest of the field that hadn't gone in yet. You can see, as you can imagine, with this many people and you see the gaps and the differences in pit stops, this would definitely shake things up. But this is probably the key moment of the race, or one of the craziest moments. Engine lets go on Project What's number 69. He tries to get below the yellow line, or below the blue line. Whoa! He gets on the banking differential, loses control, and how about that? Man, Turbo Snail is a very lucky driver. He probably needs a new suit after that one, but understandably so. Wow, that makes the Allstate Good Hands driver, whatever you want to call it. That's just the move of the year, maybe. That is some serious luck. Now you can see the packs after pit stops. This is the very back end of the pack, and then you have the people that are just got kind of messed up on the pit lane. Cheated out there. There are five cars that are just kind of in no man's land. They're in limbo. Quiet Girl and Race Car would soon take their muscle, and they would actually throw that second pack into the first pack, making it one big pack. You see this back of the pack here, led by Goofy Tyler. They say, all right, we want to get up here. We want to have a chance to win it too. You see them there as they all kind of try to uniform. They try to work something out. Race Car and Quiet Girl go to the front, so they just made their way through 20 cars or so, coming to about 20 laps to go. You can imagine they're trying frantically in that very backpack here. You see as they get into two uniform lines and begin to draft each other, and they actually begin to make some ground. You can see now that they're about 4.83 seconds back. Not long after that, they're only 3.5 seconds back. They were coming, and they were coming quickly. At the front of the pack, you can see they are not in an organized line. They are in a big mess of vehicles. Cars are strewn everywhere because they're racing for the win. Well, you can see it's still just a whole mess of cars up here, coming to about 9 laps to go. On board with Goofy Tyler. With Mega Umbreon looking at Goofy Tyler's back bumper, they are gaining with only a 2.5 second differential now. They can catch the draft of the back of that pack now. And you can see with the closing stages, they caught up. They threw themselves into this. And now they know exactly what they want to do. And that's go to the front. Goofy Tyler splitting 4 wide for 3rd place. Comes up in that Chevrolet. Throws himself into the draft and up onto the high line with 3 laps to go. You see him riding around there. BK Glover now was the leader, trying to hold off anyone he can. Now he's stuck on that outside line. But believe it or not, as we come down to 2 laps to go, Goofy Tyler starts making the outside line work. Jaggy's in the lead. He's trying to block 3 lanes of traffic. Here comes BK Glover with all kinds of horsepower. Goofy Tyler, he finished 2nd in the Daytona 400. He doesn't want to finish 2nd again at the restrictor plate. Look at the outside line moving as they train their way up next to Jaggy as they come to the white flag. White flag is in the air. They're 3 wide. Jaggy's stuck in the middle. GT Racer 98 on the inside. There's BK Glover getting pushed by Goofy Tyler. He's going to move down to the middle line. Now he's going to try to move to the very inside line. Can he stick there? He moves back to the outside line. Here comes GT Racer 98 with help. Now it's BK Glover getting an aero push from Goofy Tyler on the outside line. Cars are scattering everywhere behind him. GT Racer all by himself. The outside line's going to work for the first time today, and it's going to be where it counts the most. Goofy Tyler trying everything he can to get up to the first spot. BK Glover in the lead. GT Racer 98 on the inside. He has no help. Here comes Goofy Tyler. He makes a dive to the inside. Coming through the tri-oval. They're going to be door to door. Goofy Tyler trying to side draft BK Glover. Checkered flag. BK Glover wins the race. And look at the photo finish. Side by side coming to the line. And after reliability issues had been the issue all year, for the BK Glover team. He finally gets a well-earned victory. Look at the field all fly by. Now, this is after the race. This is on the cooldown lap. You see, all kinds of things go crazy. Jarragini, I spoke to him this morning. He was going to take that car from this track to Daytona. Well, he just ruined that. He plowed right into the back of Cod Demon. And now you see there's some bumping and shoving there. And then Doodle runs right into the back of Carbonox. In one of the strangest post-race excursions ever, you see this is on board with Jarragini. GT Racer 98 gets on the banking differentials. I mean, everybody gets stuck down there and just wham. Nowhere to go. This is just a view of the mess. I mean, just look at it. There's nowhere to go. At all. It's just a very odd occurrence there. Well, there you see the margin of victory. 0.014 seconds. Goofy Tyler there. Rally Morton in third. AJHG in fourth. GT Racer 98 fifth. Jaggy sixth. B-Man seventh. Ninners eighth. Race Car ninth. Johnny 1996 coming home 10th. Quiet Girl coming home 13th. Another strong finish for her. Turbo Snail was doing good for the majority of the day, but ended up mid-pack. The Cybertron led most of the laps, came 21st. And now the well-deserved burnouts finally coming to BK Glover. He had been doing so well in the majority of the races, but reliability had just been killing him. Last week, he finished pretty decent, but now he finally gets to taste the champagne and the 43 points. As he sits in victory lane, that's a win number one for BK Glover in the number 97 Ford. What a race he had today. Well, it's been a great race at the first restrictor plate, or the third restrictor plate of the season. Now we're headed back to where we started. We're going to Daytona for the Coke Zero 300. We'll see you there next week under the lights at Daytona.